Hezekiah was one of Judah's greatest kings. He reigned in Jerusalem 29 years, and the text says that he did what was right in the eyes of the Lord. He destroyed the people's idols, and he even destroyed the bronze snake of Moses because the people treated it like an idol. The prophet Isaiah warned Hezekiah not to ally himself with Egypt and Philistia when they go to rebel against Assyria. Hezekiah listens at first, but later he rebels. Hezekiah ended up wiping out the Philistines, but during his reign, the Assyrians destroyed the northern kingdom of Israel, and later the Assyrians even capture all of Judah's fortified cities, and Hezekiah bribes the Assyrian king Sennacherib with gold and silver from the royal and temple treasuries to convince him to stay out of Jerusalem for a while at least. Later, Sennacherib's troops surrounded Jerusalem again, and the field commander called out to the people of Jerusalem, saying, "On what are you basing this confidence of yours? Pharaoh will not be able to save you from us. We will give you a good new land to live in if you surrender to us. Will Yahweh really protect you? Haven't you been unfaithful to Yahweh? None of the gods of the other nations of the world were able to save their people from our might. Yahweh himself told us to march against Jerusalem and destroy it. Surely you will all eat your own dung and drink your own piss." But the people remained silent as Hezekiah had commanded them. And Hezekiah put on sackcloth and went into the temple, and he sent for the prophet Isaiah, the son of Amoz. Hezekiah hoped that God would rebuke the Assyrians for their blasphemy and save Jerusalem, and Isaiah gave this message to King Hezekiah. "This is what the Lord says. Do not be afraid of what you have heard, those words with which the underlings of the king of Assyria have blasphemed me. Listen, when he hears a certain report, I will make him once return to his own country, and there I will have him cut down with the sword." And so the Assyrians ended up retreating because of threats of a Cushite invasion from the African continent. And as they left, they sent a letter to Hezekiah threatening that they would eventually come back and conquer Jerusalem, and no one would be able to stop them then. And Hezekiah offered a prayer to the Lord, saying, "It is true that the Assyrians have destroyed the gods of other nations, because they were not really gods at all. Now, Lord, our God, deliver us from his hand, so that all the kingdoms of the earth may know that you alone, Lord, are God." Here's a condensed version of Isaiah's message about Sennacherib. "Virgin daughter Zion despises you and mocks you. Daughter Jerusalem tosses her head as you flee. Who is it you have ridiculed and blasphemed? Against whom have you raised your voice and lifted your eyes in pride? Against the Holy One of Israel. Therefore, this is what the Lord says concerning the king of Assyria. He will not enter this city or shoot an arrow here. He will not come before it with shield or build a siege ramp against it. By the way that he came, he will return. He will not enter this city, declares the Lord. I will defend the city and save it for my sake and for the sake of David, my servant." And then the text says that the angel of the Lord slaughtered 185,000 Assyrian soldiers at night, and Sennacherib returned to his capital at Nineveh. And after he returned, his own two sons assassinated him, and Esarhaddon became king of Assyria. Later on, Hezekiah becomes deathly ill, and so Isaiah sends him a message saying, "Get your house in order, because you're gonna die." But Hezekiah offers a plea, and he faces the wall and cries, and he asks God to remember his faithfulness. Isaiah leaves, but then God stops him and sends him back with a new message, saying, "God has heard you. God will heal you. God will protect the city from the Assyrians." But Hezekiah asks for a sign from God, and so the sign was given that the shadow would move backwards up the steps instead of following its normal course down the steps during the day. And Hezekiah recovered from his illness. Later on, King Marduk-Baladan of Babylon is pleased that Hezekiah has recovered, and so he sends some envoys from the nation of Babylon with gifts for him. And Hezekiah shows off all of Jerusalem's wealth to the envoys, and Isaiah scolds him and predicts that one day the king of Babylon will come to plunder Jerusalem's wealth. But Hezekiah doesn't really care. He figures he'll be long gone by then. And finally, one other thing Hezekiah was famous for was building an extensive tunnel and water system under the city of Jerusalem in order to make sure that the city would never run out of water in the events of a long siege, which did eventually happen, but we'll learn more about that in another episode.